Starting tonight with the oil spill disaster, and before today, the oil threat was mostly to the barrier islands of our state. Today, it started hitting the state's mainland. Blobs of oil spotted on the beaches of Biloxi all the way down to Pascagoula. Governor Haley Barbour demanding more skimmers be brought in to stop the problem before it gets worse. BP says it's within 20 feet horizontally of tapping a relief well to the one gushing so much oil. But that still won't be operational until the 1st of August. 16 WAPT's Catherine Kite on why this is creating a first-of-its-kind threat this hurricane season.
Oil that Mother Nature kept away for months from the Mississippi coast has now washed ashore.
I mean, we can go to the moon and all of that, but we can't stop an oil leak. Don't seem right.
Thousands of volunteers have been going to the beach since oil started hitting coastlines. But MEMA spokesman Jeff Rent says all those volunteers are adding new worries for this hurricane season.
We have a lot of people who weren't on the coast last year that are now. They're working the oil spill cleanup or response to the oil. So that's one of the things to consider. The other thing is there could be potential contaminants due to oil in the water if we were to have some sort of tidal surge.
Dan Douglas and Mike Vizina are two of those volunteers.
It's all been washing up, and it's just getting worse and worse, and nobody's plugging the dang thing.
Well, I don't feel like they're doing anything. And I feel like the reason nobody's doing anything is because whoever starts doing anything is going to be the ones that gets blamed for it when it doesn't work.
This week, the Department of Environmental Quality is testing water, air, and tar balls on the coast. As of right now, the DEQ says those tests have come back below any level of concern. But residents we talk to say our state's economy is in jeopardy.
Everybody I know are going to the mountains. They usually go, you know, to the coast. They're all going to the mountains now.
Roy Holmes says despite the oil and storms in the Gulf, he's still heading to Biloxi for the holiday weekend.
Well, I just hope there's a lot of people down there, but I doubt it is going to be, you know. We just ride and look, enjoy the scenery.
Even if that scenery includes tar balls and oil sheens. Catherine Kite, 16 WAPT News.
Now we're bringing back in Storm Shield 16 Chief Meteorologist David Hartman to tell us exactly how the storm is going to impact this oil spill, at least how we think it could.
Well, minimal impact, but it does look like some impact. There is a fairly large circulation with Alex, and it's becoming better organized. And as the winds strengthen, it will churn up the Gulf. Switch over to live Storm Shield 16 Doppler radar, and this is a graphic showing wave heights. And there you see the projected path of Alex across the western Gulf towards Brownsville, Texas. But where you see all that yellow, those are wave heights in excess of 10 feet. The oil spill is right up here where waves are approaching about 5.5 feet this morning. And that, combined with southeasterly winds, is helping to spread the oil out. And I think that'll continue to be the trend, Scott. These big waves, which will churn things up, stir the Gulf up a little bit, probably spread the oil out, southeast winds, really pushing the oil slick a little bit closer to the Mississippi coast, something we've been spared so far.
We know the